Hey, you guys. Let's celebrate. And have story time. Good story. My grandma, my sister, my uncle, and myself at the Velvet Turtle Restaurant. Oh my goodness, good times. Well, this was back in the, I'm gonna say early 70s. For those of you, do you remember Velvet Turtle restaurants? They were like the top of the line, fancy, fancy restaurants. Like, up there with Red Lobster, maybe above Red Lobster. Anyway. I also have coffee here on the side. So anyways, it was something special for, I don't know why, maybe it was Mother's Day or my grandma's birthday. I can remember that sitting at the table as if it was yesterday. Oh my goodness, this is just a fun memory. So my grandma lived over in East Los Angeles, and at the time my uncle was living there with her, and my sister, I was like probably junior high, my sister, grammar school, and we were staying a weekend with my grandma, and my uncle, he would do little nice things when we were there, and this time he takes us to Velvet. I was junior high, and I was all about glamour and movie stars and fancy stuff, and I thought, oh my goodness, this is the best restaurant I've ever been to. But the funny part was, my grandma could not figure it out. I remember my uncle saying to my grandma, come on, when you get dressed up, I'm going to take you to a nice restaurant to eat. Oh, my grandma's so cute. Yeah, her little pocketbook, and we go. Unfortunately, she didn't smile that much. And looking back, I'm totally convinced she was so confused. You have to know, my grandma, she lived till her 80s. She died like in mid to late 1980s, I think. Was an immigrant from Poland, and they lived in this little Polish community. She understood English, and she spoke English, but very limited. Anyways, she, I think, was so confused at the name of the restaurant, the Velvet Turtle. Remember, in the parking lot, it, for some reason, I remember seeing a wooden restaurant with a wooden frame. And you see the Velvet Turtle, and you see a picture of the turtle. I do not remember my grandma smiling once the whole evening. She wasn't upset. But I'm wondering now if the straight face was the confusion. And the more straight-faced my grandma was, the harder my uncle, my sister, and myself laughed. And you guys know how I am when I get going laughing. And trust me, between my sister and my uncle, it was so contagious. I'm surprised they didn't ask us to leave. But anyways, Oh, I know how I thought of this story. I was doing a going through the grocery list, and they had filet mignon, and that's the kind of the crux of this story. So we get seated, and then the waiter brings us our menu, and my grandma, I think she was just stunned at the price per at the meal. My uncle, he wanted us all to have filet mignon, especially his mother. That was his mother. So, that was his mother, wanted us to have filet. And she sees the price, and I do believe from that moment on, it was when her seriousness began. My uncle realized it. And so he said, "Come on, Mom, let's have some." And he wanted to make us laugh, because remember, my sister's in grammar school, I'm in junior high, and still young enough to be silly. And oh, look at this. White chocolate. Nice. But you know me, I have to have like a real chocolate. Look at this. They did it right. Oh my goodness, delicious. You really do have to have a jumbo strawberry for this, but anyways. So, excuse me, there goes my throat. And my uncle, sorry, sorry, come on, Mom. Let me order you some filet mignon or fillet mignon. He said it really funny. And he started cackling. My grandma didn't laugh. He says, "Let me order you some fillet mignon." Even my little sister laughed because we knew he was saying it all wrong. And she kept looking at him and talking. I said, "This it? I know the price just overwhelmed her." And he kept saying it over and over again. He said, "Mom, it's my treat. We're gonna all have fillet mignon." And my grandma, I think she was discouraged with her own English, because in her mind she knew that wasn't how the word. She knew the word was filet mignon, but my uncle kept saying fillet mignon. And he was serious about it, but then when me and my sister would laugh, he would laugh. So my poor grandma, the whole night she was in such confusion. I think first to think, is this really a restaurant? It's a velvet turtle. So what is she thinking? Is it a restaurant where you go and you eat, have like turtle soup or turtle stuff? I don't know, but I hadn't thought of that story in forever. And oh, but for some reason today I did think about it. And so they bring the meal, and it's a small piece of meat. It's not like a huge, like a porterhouse or T-bone steak. You know that. My grandma, beautiful waiter. For some reason, I remember the waiters and waitresses being in like black and white, very nice and elegant uniforms. And they bring our meals. My grandma look looking down at her plate. She looks at it, and she had the old time grandma, you know, eyeglasses. You know, think of her grandparents back in the 70s and 80s. Truly different than the grandparents of today. And she looks down at her plate, and she looks up at my uncle. And you can tell she's so confused, like, this is it for that price? She didn't say it, but you just knew. We knew how my grandma was. And so, I think my uncle knew also. I said, what's wrong, Mom? And she kind of didn't say much, and she kind of, like, looked around her plate, you know, as if to say, is this it? Is this the meal for the prince? And So I sure miss my grandma. That's the same grandma when I've shared pizza stories. She's the grandma that loved to go to Shakey's Pizza Parlor when his grandkids would spend the weekend with her, and she'd get a pitcher of beer, and we'd have pizza, beer, and fried chicken, and we'd have so much fun. Huh. I'm curious, was velvet turtle just a California thing? So I just remember my sister and my uncle and myself just laughing, really laughing, like the whole meal. And of course we had doggy bags, and that really threw my grandma for a loop, because I think she's trying to figure out about the turtle, the velvet turtle. And when we said we're going to have doggy bags, my grandma was not familiar with the take-home term of a doggy bag. And say, Mom, where's your doggy bag? Oh, she is so serious. Oh my goodness, I miss both of them. My grandma, my uncle. I miss the 70s. Good times. It is interesting though, when I think of my grandparents, the look of our grandparents, when we had grandparents in the 60s and 70s, then here are the grandparents of today, that same age. It's like night and day. And it's just a fun memory. I love to go down memory lane with you guys. And to eat cake. Oh, this was such a fun surprise. These chocolate dipped strawberries. I tried to make them so many times at home. It's never good like this. Came from the strawberry fields. Delicious. Well, happy Mother's Day today, and thank you to all of you who watch the ads before my videos. It means a lot. And to those of you who subscribe, to those of you who like, push the like button, and those of you sharing my videos, it really does mean a lot. And thanks for watching.